gut süß, ne? What are you doing, you weirdo? What are you doing, you weirdo? The wind's about to blow us down. What are you doing? What are you doing? You wanna come here and see girls? No, that'd be a bad idea. All right, we're going to the barn. You gonna stay here? We got a mess at the barn to do. Look, there come them other two calves. A little bit cool out here this morning. Where you going? Hold on a minute. Oh, you're getting dirt on me. Quit. And you're duking too. Alright, you threw your fit. You done with your fit? Alright.
Well, welcome back. We got a few things to do this morning. It's a little cloudy. A few rain showers probably moving through a little bit today, and the wind's up a little bit more than I thought it was going to be, but we're going to try to go to the barn today and do a few things. Got to do some things in the hog pen today, and already been to the feed store and back, so we got that out of the way. But been here visiting with Bella and Elsie this morning, and Elmo, and
I think he got a little mad at us for here visiting. He couldn't go in there and see him. Are you still mad?
But come on, let's go to the barn and we'll see if we can get some stuff done today before that rain comes in. I don't remember if I ever told y'all before or not, but it's always good to keep hay string with you. You always need something around, especially when you got somebody like Elmo around who knows how to open your latches. Because if I don't tie this latch down, he'll be in here before we get done today. So I gotta figure out how to tie this latch down so he don't unhook it. All right. Well, I'm gonna try to put that trough in here so I can feed Elmo and the rest of the cows in here, especially when it's raining. We got rain coming today and everything. So I'm gonna go ahead and try to get that trough in here today. I've got the gate shut so Elmo can't get in, got it tied down so he can't get the latch. And so what I need to do first is I gotta get this board right here put back on. They had kind of knocked it off. I'm gonna try to nail it back into place and get it fixed. Try to get it lined back up in the old nail holes that we had there before. What I'm gonna do to make sure it stays on this time, because these old nails, they'll push back out if they get to pushing against it. I'm gonna put some of these old deck screws back in like I did the other side over there. That way I'll make sure they stay in. That'll 10 back up. It's burning my finger.
So now we're using the same screws to keep this tin back up there because the nail has pulled out of it too. There's the old nail that was in it, but I'm going to start this thing with my hammer and then we'll drive it in with the other thing. Probably ain't the way you need to do it, but that's the only way to get through that tin. Now that's fixed, we'll get the trough in there.
Sit down, middle way. Let's push up against that post. Alright, that's good. Alright, now, let's see if I can get a couple T-posts and get it anchored down the ground so Emma don't push it back and forth in here like it does outside. So what we're going to try to do is we're going to try to stake this trough back down in the ground like we did before outside with these T-posts. And well, we know how that turned out last time with Elmo. But if I put in here, the ground's gonna be a little drier and it won't get as wet and they'll stay in the ground better. But you can see I'm not using any brand new T-post. These are some of the T-posts that Elmo's already destroyed before. So we're gonna repurpose these because it's just an experiment anyway. So let's see if we can get these buried in the ground. As hard as that was to get in the ground, I hope he can't pull it out, because when they built this shutter probably 35 years ago, they had some crushed run rock poured in here to make a good foundation for it to put dirt on top. And so trying to get through them rocks to stay in the ground, it's a little hard to do, but I hope as hard as it was to get in, it's even that much harder for him to get them back out. Just in case, we're gonna put these caps back on there. Just so they don't, I don't think they'll get it very close enough to scratch the seals or stick their seals on. Just in case, that keeps getting cut on this thing. All right, got that done. So let's see how long it takes Elmo to tear this one out of stall. But I think you have a little harder time in here. You ain't got as much room to move around. Well, since we're working on Charles mess today, I got another issue with the hogs. They tear up more than Elmo does. So we're gonna go ahead while we're getting the T-post put in the ground. I'm gonna go ahead and move their trough. Because as you can see, they've rooted this whole place up in here. So they ain't a level place anywhere out here anymore. About the only level place is right there. Oh, get out of the way. About the only level place is right there. So what I'm gonna do, as you can see, they're moving their feet around pretty good too. So I'm gonna end up setting it right up there on that level ground. I'm gonna put some T-posts around it too. Maybe that'll keep them from moving it around as much as Elmo had been doing his other trough. But while I'm here, I want to show you their house that we were so proud when we built. Show you just how tough these old hogs are. Hey, here's their house. Go on now, get. Here's their house. And believe it or not, this is the good side. So let's walk around the other side over here. Get on out of the way, hog. There's the front door view. You can see it goes right on through to the back door view now. But I tell you one thing. This stuff here on the side might be good for a top, because the top looks pretty decent right on. But it ain't much on the side, because like I say, I put them screws in it right there.
And then you see it. Anyhow, she's pulled right through when they went through the sides of this thing. And she's just a big old mess. So that's it wasn't gonna be permitted anyway. And that right there is probably why. They love to rub and waller and everything else. So it won't permit it anyhow. So when I get ready to do the next pen, well, you quit trying to bite my leg. When I get ready to do the next pen, we'll have some better stuff out here. We'll make it out of regular 5E10. And Lord have mercy, she's gonna knock my leg off. Hey, man, you gotta get on, you crazy sow. Anyhow, they won't be here much longer. I got a date for them about 2 weeks from now. So we'll get a new crop in after that. Oh, Lord have mercy. And see if we can get this place rebuilt before then. And if you want to smell something that smells real, real good, smell that right there. It'll stay on your hands 2 or 3 days. You can't use any kind of soap that I can think of. Anybody knows the kind of soap to get hog stuff off your hands, let me know. And what I'm gonna have to do is, I don't really want to, but I'm gonna have to put one on each, the front and the back too, because if not, they'll push it right between these two right here. So I'm gonna try to get it to where it don't bother the flaps, but it's just enough where they can't push it back and forth through. Well, that's kind of working, but I think I'm gonna have to do one more thing. I think I'm gonna get me a tie down strap, go around these two posts, and tie it down right here. Because like I said, they've already moved it back and forth a little bit. And if they move it back and forth too much, these posts are gonna block the lid. I got them back far enough now it would be okay, but I think I can do a ratchet strap. Tighten it down, tie it up to both of these, I think it'd be okay. Be able to move it now, that strap, but I do know I'm gonna have to do something with this strap right here, because they're already trying to eat it already. So if I leave anything dangling, they're gonna get it. So tuck it back over here. Alright, so I can still get my lid open, I can get the feed in it. I don't think they're gonna be able to move around too much. So now we're gonna load this thing up with feed. Well, go on now. There's 250 pounds of feed right there. That should get them through and top them out. And that should get them through until we have to carry them to town. Well, the girls have come into the barn and they have found a new trough over there. And they've been sniffing at it, checking it out a little bit. And now I hear Elmo, he's a-coming. He thinks there's something in the barn here to eat, but not quite ready time for eating yet. So we'll wait and see how Elmo likes it when he comes in here and checks that new trough out. See if he tries to tear it up or not. What do you think, Betsy? Is he gonna try to tear it up? Well, I reckon now.
Elmo's out there with
Elmo? It ain't been here 2 hours yet, and you already trying to tear it up. Now, me and you's gonna have to have a meeting about this. Yeah, you might as well go on. He's trying.
They already tore the calf off of
him. Well, no, that's one of them heifers that tore that off. Matter of fact, it was that one right yonder. No. That one right yonder nosing on it a while ago. Well, Elmo has done found a trough. He's done cut his noggin right there on the trough already, being stupid. It's sore, ain't it? Hurts, don't it? So it's gonna hurt a little bit more when I spray this on there. Ooh, that's burning, ain't it? That burn in your head? Yeah, but you got to have it on there so you don't get no nasty stuff in there. Come here. Put some more on there. Come here. Come here. Hold still now. Oh, yeah. Ooh, that burns. Mm. It's turning me purple, too.
Mm. You gotta wash your hands or you never get that off.
No, I'll have purple fingers for a day or two. All right. When you leave the trough alone, we'll find out where that sharp edge was and see where it was. I knew what it is. You had it up on that head trying to push it off them posts is what you were doing.
You need that one.
Exactly what you
put
were doing.
Put that yellow cap back on it.
Exactly
there.
What you was doing. All right, throw this out there so I can get it out of the way. Are you being nosy? Are you being nosy? All right, big head. Quit trying to knock my trough over now. Can't even get sawdust in the feed bags right you out here making noises and doing stupid stuff. Well, let's try this again, since Elmo found a trough and trying to tear it up already, and now my hands is purple. So what we're getting ready to do is take and get this sawdust up, get it out the back of this truck, and do something with it. One of my YouTube folks the other day said, hey, since you got all these feed sacks right here, why don't you go ahead and put all that sawdust in the feed sack, then we can move around easier. So I think that's what we're gonna do. We've actually did the chicken coop twice with what I've already got so far, and we still got enough to probably do it two more times. But I want to get out of the back of the old Ford truck. I want to go ahead and store it somewhere and get it out of here so I can use the old Ford truck a little bit more. So we're gonna bag it up real quick and send me bags we'll get out of what's left. This old dustpan might be the easiest way to do it. Might have to hold the other side of the bag. Yeah, this is the best way to do it, right? Yep. Give me some pastry. That's not a bad little bag right there, and it's not real heavy, so that's going to be an ideal thing. He's in there banging that trough again. I might have to beat him to death.
He's probably
going to have to stand and take that. All right. So we'll take some old hay string. We'll wrap around this bag about 3 or 4 times. And we'll tie it off. Like that, and there we go. We got us a bag of shavings, sawdust to put back in there for the chicken pen. Elmo, what are you doing? Get out of that trough. You better get out of there. Get out of under there, you big dummy. Quick. Now look what you done. Now how am I gonna get that back down? Couldn't hit one time on enough, was it? Well. Boy, I'm gonna get the stick out of you. All right now, you better quit. All right, we're gonna have to. Well, he's got it down now, so let me come right back.
Well, Elmo got the first round, but I'm fixing to get the second round. Yeah, you know what you done. You know what you done.
Yeah.
So, try something different. See if this works. Since he's going up under it, to try to wire it down. I think I had it wired down before. It took him a little bit longer to get it undone. So let's try that again. We'll see how that goes. Knothead. Oh, me. He's about got my T-post out right over here, though. That's all right. I'm going to try it this way. You would have gone. I don't need no help. You would have gone? No. Go on. Quit. Go on now. You already made me your name. Go on. Go on. I don't need no help. You're probably trying to watch what I'm doing so you can tear it up when I get out of here. Watch out, someone cut you this wire. You big dunny. Don't be watching what I'm doing, because you ain't gonna turn it back up now. I ain't even fixed it the first time in it, and you're already tearing it up. Back up now, I can't see what I'm doing. Don't knock my hat off. I don't need a bag. Go on somewhere now. Can you go on somewhere? Go on somewhere.
You're about to worry me now. You're about to worry me now. You got to go on. I can't even get stuff done.
All right, we're going to try that for a little while and see how that does. Like I said, the sorry sucker ain't even got fed the first time in it. He's already trying to tear it up. But if he don't, if he tears it up, we'll take it out. We'll let him start eating out of the wooden trough like he's been out of bin and just be that way. Well, we're going to try to feed it the first time with a new trough in here. Elmo's about to turn up a couple times a day, so we're going to try now. And so we're going to try it now, see how it works. I think it's going to work out pretty good, though. Well, if we can keep Elmo from turning the trough up, I think it's going to work out pretty good. But like I say, you saw earlier how he got up under it and was trying to tear it up. But I got it wired back down again, T-posted back in the ground again, and we're going to see what they do. If he tears it up, I'll just take it back out and they'll start eating out of the wooden trough again. And there comes Betsy. Come on, Betsy. Well, we got the old full truck cleaned out, and we ended up with 13 bags of sawdust shavings. And so that's enough probably to chicken coop at least a couple more times. So that was a good little trip. And we appreciate the neighbor letting us know about it so we'd come get it. I think I kind of like the sawdust better than I do the shavings. It seemed like a little easier to move around and stuff. So I think I might try to start using shavings from here on out in the coop. Well, I think we're going to wind it up for today. We've had a time out here. We've got a lot of stuff done that we wanted to do today. But we've had a lot of wind out here today. I mean, the wind's really been blowing. It's been a nice day, but the wind's been really heavy. And we went to take our trash off a little bit ago, and we're coming back up the path to the house, and my neighbor was in the backfield. They were taking soil samples today, and he sent me a text and said, emergency, wind damage. And by the time I saw Maggie running through the front yard going down the driveway. So we stopped and got her and brought her back. And I'll be doggone. Now, last Saturday, the wind got up like this and turned the dog pen over. It got the sunscreen that was on it, flipped the dog pen upside down, scared her to death. And it didn't mess the dog pen up too much. It kind of messed up just a little bit. But we got it back together, turned it back up right like it ought to be. And then by the time we were going to take trash off this afternoon, we came back, it had done it again. So this time we decided we got lucky. It didn't fold up completely on her. If it did, it would have hurt her pretty bad. But it apparently just picked up, flipped over, she ran out from under. So we're not going to try that again. The way the wind is, we took the sunscreen off and everything. But it, of course, it messed her dog pen up pretty good this time. I got some pictures. I'll try to put it in this video. But she's a guardian livestock dog anyway. She'll be 6 months old at the end of this month. So we wanted to put her here with the cows anyway. So we decided to go ahead and take the pen down and put her here with Buck and Elsie and Bella and see how she does. And they've done pretty good so far today. So we went ahead and put her dog pen out here. And she stayed with them, and she didn't get it to the fence today, but she kind of wanted to come back out in the yard with us. But she stayed. She did pretty good. And they're just all trying to get used to each other. So it's been a day. So hopefully she'll do good out here with them. And of course, we got Elmo and his crowd settled in. Finally got the trough stuff situated. And we had us a pretty good meeting this afternoon about that trough. And I'm hoping that he has decided to leave it alone. But we'll see how it goes. If you don't, I can always take it back out and they can eat out the wooden troughs that's actually built into the ground. So this makes it a little bit easier in case anybody else needs to feed up for us while we're gone or something. But if not, we'll just have to do something else. Well, that's gonna wrap it up for us. Again, we appreciate you joining us. Thanks again for watching. And please like, share, and subscribe. Leave us some comments down below. And there again, I can't think of your name right off the top of my head, but the guy who commented a while back about this sawdust shavings in the feed sacks, that was a good idea. We ended up with about 13 bags of that, enough to do the coop about two more times at least. And I think we're going to start doing the sawdust instead of the shavings. They seem like they're a little easier to handle, and seem like they actually absorb the stuff that we need to absorb a little bit better. So again, we appreciate it, and we'll see you on the next video.